Alrighty, so today I'm talking about taming wild nature a little bit. Today I was gardening. Now, out there, there's a moment in the garden where you find resistance and you find takeover. You find killer plants that wanted to kill another plant. So here's the ivy, and there's the succulents. I'll call them the jade. So there's the ivy, it goes through, it crisscrosses through, and another under, and another under, and it stunts it, and so it can't grow. So we have this overtaker. You know, so we're dealing with the overtaker ivy. And I'm like, well, you know, I have to be some kind of conformist back into and toward the Zen garden of control. I have to stop it in its tracks. I have to, because in a way I'm like, well, it's going to kill it. You know, it's going to kill that succulent. So instead of, you know, if I didn't do anything, you know, am I the damner to it, you know? So I would be the non-helper. You know what I'm saying? So there I have done a good deed to that one plant. But to the other, to the ivy, I am an absolute killer of its life. There's killer of its life tendrils. It still has many more, though. It has many more, so I don't feel so persecuted in guilt. But when we're looking at Jainism, when we're looking at the sanctuary space, don't hurt the plants at all. Don't touch the plants. Don't touch the consciousness state of it. You know, each little tip, each tendril has something to say to another in its own discussion, its own discourse, its own communication. And it's not really for me to take part and go and say, no, you can't have the discussion. You know what I'm saying? You can't have that viable moment. But yet, here we are in city states or whatever, and so we're doing this. We're doing these meanders, and we're making these choices, and we're being the school teacher. We're saying, okay, that's it. You have no. You have no given. I have given you no. I have had to say, put you back to the very beginning, you know, sometimes. With a plant, you go back to the very beginning. So yeah, there's a lot of guilt going on with the yogi self, when you are dealing with nature and you're telling it to curtail. There are a lot of guilts when you also are dealing with, but then further on, we can look at Zen, we can look at the Zen gardens and go, they've gone too far. They're fanatic. They've not allowed any even sort of entrainment to happen. Like when you prune a tree, there is entrainment. It'll go there and it'll stop. You know, where you cut the twig zone, and it'll go another way. You say, yes, because it hurt there. I don't want to continue, it hurt. So it goes the other way. Alright, so, yeah, no, today I was even worse. I had done that before, and then it went the other way, and then I had to cut it again. So now I'm making it go, no, you can't go this way, and blocking it, you know, and it's just like, I just... But it's okay, because there's more of it, you know, it wasn't the original. If it was just this one little twig that sprouted out of the ground and you were doing that to it, that cruelly, that would just be a damner. But there were many, 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 many twigs. Many twigs, but still it's a terrible directional to keep giving this one little sprout. So yeah. You have to think about kindness. There has to be kindness, and not a cruelty given to pruning any kind of plant. Yeah, direct here, no. Direct here, no. You know, direct here, no. I mean, you don't do that to human beings. So why would you do that to a plant? You know, you don't want that to be done to yourself. Okay, so here we are. We're out there at the Zens now. Now I'm looking at the Zen gardens and I'm going, well, swell, you know, they're all, you know, in their format. But they're so stylized and they're so perfect that I don't believe there is a utopia for nature to live there. I don't believe so. I think that's a formed utopia by the Zen provider of man, the man who actually was the gardener. So nature itself is not experiencing its utopia, its diplomacy moment. It's not allowed that interchange and communication in the Zen gardens. And yet, they look beautiful. They look like they're never gonna be upset, blah blah blah. However, I don't think when we're looking at the switch there, I think that is man's utopia version. I think that's the Zen man's utopia version of a garden, and not actually nature's utopia version. So when we have nature's utopia version of the garden, you know, fitting in to that reality, then that can be a beautiful consciousness state for all. When you have the man, the Zen man, and the nature, you know, provided for, rather than just the graded rakes of the valleys as a bird would fly over, you know, rather than that predicament always seen. So any hoot, yeah, so I guess I was talking about the stability structure of nature and utopia, and utopia itself, you know, nature and utopia, you know, and if it keeps getting cut and hurt, no, I don't think that's utopia. I think that's just another cruel given. So yeah, so when you prune, try to just be very gentle and realize there are overtakers, and they're the ones that you really, really should never feel persecuted against or guilty at getting at, you know. But, you know, you don't have to go overboard. You know, give them their chance. They are supposed to be a little flourishy extra. So, anyhoot, that's it. It was just about gardening today and guilts. Yogi guilts with gardening.